You are about to see the fascinating science and engineering behind digital pianos. We chose to reverse engineer and analyze Casio's CTK-800 because of our collective passion for music, and our desire to understand the aspects of translating the pressing of a key to the output of a pitch. As we begin our disassembly, we first remove the various screws on the back of our CTK-800 keyboard, highlighted in blue. We can do this simply by using a common screwdriver found in any day living. As we disassemble the keyboard, we will give a brief introduction into the history of electronic keyboard technology.
Electronic keyboards, also called synthesizers, are instruments that produce sound by pressing keys using electricity similarly to its successors, pipe organs and harpsichords. Organs date back 24 centuries. The hydraulis, or water organ, invented by the Romans in 3rd century BC, forced air through reed pipes and was powered by a manual water pump or waterfall. As technology progressed, improvements to the piano were added. Despite these developments, early pianos did not have keyboards, but were instead operated by levers or buttons. In fact, black and white keys did not become standardized until the 1300s. Widespread adoption of electronic sound in the 1920s revolutionized the piano. Electronic instruments such as the theremin and trontonium were especially popular. The electronic piano became what it is now today because of the invention of solid-state transistors and musical instrumental digital interface. MIDI allows digital code to be transmitted to synthesizers, allowing computers to be connected for input, thereby launching the keyboard into the digital age.
After removing all the external screws, we expose the backing of the keys and open up the piano to reveal the electrical components within.
The first electrical component of the keyboard to be addressed is the AC power adapter, which is the main source of power for the other components. Most standard keyboards use 9 volts for the entire board. The power adapter is composed of 3 main parts: the transformer, the capacitor, and several diodes. The transformer is composed of the primary and secondary coil, which make the voltage from 120 volts coming out of the wall outlet to 9 volts utilized by the keyboard. The diodes convert alternating current to direct current. This direct current is actually a pulsating direct current and oscillates. The smoothing capacitor serves the purpose of smoothing out the pulsating direct current into a steady stream to be used by the components. The alternating current from the wall outlet means that each slit alternates between positive and negative charge extremely fast. The prongs and wires feed these alternating currents into a diode circuit that directs all negative charges into one wire and all positive charges into another.
After understanding the power system of our electric keyboard, we can now analyze the translation of a key to the signals transmitted.
Part of the power provided by the AC adapter goes into powering the keyboard matrix circuit. This circuit serves as the component that reads user input or keystrokes of the keyboard. This particular model uses an 8x8 matrix to measure each individual keystroke without having a wire connected to every single key. Each key corresponds to one place in the 8x8 matrix. Keys in a simple 8x8 matrix circuit are binary and are either recorded by the motherboard as on or off. This keyboard is not equipped with velocity sensors that can register touch and greater dynamics found on higher-end keyboards. However, these systems work with a double sensor method where the initial touch is recorded by one and the final touch is recorded by a second. The difference in time between these measures allows the piano to know if the note was played in a sharp staccato manner, indicative of a short time period, or a long legato manner, indicative of a longer period.
Once analyzed by the code, we discover the components used for displaying a visual action in response of the user.
The screen on the piano is used to guide the users on the key that they press, their selected settings, and other features associated with the keyboard. Within the manufacturing of the keyboard, this is regularly referred to as the display. The display on the CTK-800 series is similar to the means to display used on your TI-84 calculators and early renditions of Game Boys, where there are monochromatic pixels specific to shape and area for an easy-to-manipulate image. The specific screen is backlit with a blue light upon startup for view in areas of different shaded lighting. To make display an easier and cheaper process, a permanent layout of note staffs, hands, and other settings were stamped to the outer cover of the display. This design was supposed to be used for teaching an early pianist about proper positioning of fingers on the keyboard for each song and location of notes on either the treble clef staff or the bass clef staff. Matrices of pixels are at the ends of the fingers and each note on the staff, in addition to locations for the settings and numbers.
In addition to visual interpretation, a key is processed by the sound chip.
A sound chip is an integrated circuit with the purpose of helping the keyboard produce sound by, in this case, converting digital to analog. An integrated circuit is a set of electronic circuits on one small plate. Digital refers to electrical impulses or binary patterns that computers use to represent sound. Analog refers to the sound that we actually hear, like the waves that travel through a medium. Sound chips are what allow the keyboard to produce noises that resemble piano instead of just simple beeps. Sound chips take digital data recorded in the keyboard and convert it to an analog form to be audiated by the speakers.
The motherboard is the connective backbone of all the electrical components. The keyboard matrix and buttons all send input to the motherboard. The CPU, the processing unit, and the RAM, the fast short-term memory, are the main two components that deal with this input. The RAM stores button and keystrokes, and the CPU carries out the necessary commands to execute them. The motherboard also sends digital directions for analog sound to the sound chip. Also, it should be noted that on this keyboard, in addition to these features, the motherboard also houses the screen and handles the direct contact/input of the volume and button features.
The next and final step in the process is transitioning the note from segments of code to sound.
One of the most essential items in this keyboard is the sound system. The speakers are able to transfer the press of a key into frequency that determines pitch and tone. The engineering divisions included in a speaker are mechanical, electrical, material science, and engineering physics. The main components inside a speaker is the outer core, an electromagnet in the form of a coil, a permanent magnet, and the inner core made from paper. The frame of the speaker, or outer core, is made from aluminum. The permanent magnet attached to the frame consists of iron oxide, strontium, and a ceramic binder to make this a strong magnet. Housed above this is an elastic, soft material created as a paper coated with a glue. The reason for using the treated paper is because of the way that it is designed to act when vibrated. Above the outer cone, attached to the softer inner shell, is a coil that acts as an electromagnet. The magnet is controlled by changing the voltage applied to the electromagnet through means of the motherboard control. This coil causes the soft outer shell to vibrate, creating tiny sound waves. These sound waves are longitudinal waves. As the outside paper vibrates, it pushes on the air particles surrounding it, creating waves. The air has compressions and refractions, where the air is closer together and further apart, creating waves that dictate the wavelengths. Sound is also often depicted as a pressure wave because of the nature of pressure-based compression in a sound wave. The process includes controlling pressure, compression, and time to control variables of a wave. The wavelengths controlled in a specific pattern can dictate frequencies and volume, demonstrated on the keyboard by how hard a person presses and which key they press. In physics, this can be expressed with the equation velocity equals frequency multiplied by wavelength. Minor changes in waves can change the way that a frequency is perceived, creating the possibility for tone manipulation. This specific Casio keyboard device has around 500 tones that were established. In a traditional instrument, tones change based on the shape of the object that resonates with the sound. A speaker can be used to artificially create these sounds by the way at which the inner cone vibrates. To put it simply, pitch is created by how fast the electromagnet vibrates, and the volume is determined by how hard the electromagnet vibrates.
After discovering the parts inside of the keyboard itself, the next step is to understand how these parts are manufactured.
Injection molding was used to create the plastic casing, piano keys, and buttons. This manufacturing process can be done with metals, rubber, and most commonly thermoplastics. First, the material is fed into a heated barrel and then melted using heated bands. A rotating screw then forces the molten plastic along the barrel and into a vented mold. The temperature of the vented mold is controlled to prevent distortion and stress. The mold opens and the part is ejected using ejector pins. One of the materials used in injection molding include ABS. It is the thermoplastic polymer the plastic casing is made out of. Its mechanical properties include impact resistance and toughness.
Another interesting manufacturing process is that of the development of circuits.
Printed circuit boards, or PCBs, are created using a series of manufacturing processes beginning with panelization, which is when a number of PCBs are grouped onto the panel and then cut into individual circuits with a laser. Copper patterning then replicates a drawing of a computer design on the copper foil layer of the circuit board. Semi-additive processes applies an additional copper layer, which parts of are then stripped away to reveal the design. Next, holes are drilled and the PCB is galvanized, which is essentially coating it with zinc to prevent rusting. Lastly, to assemble, the components are soldered onto pads. The PCB in this electric keyboard specifically uses reflow soldering. The parts are assembled in a reflow oven or under an infrared lamp and soldered with a hot air pencil.
With knowledge of the components and manufacturing aspects of the piano, it is possible for us to brainstorm ways to improve the creation of a keyboard.
Using additive manufacturing would revolutionize the process for creating printed circuit boards. It uses less material, thereby producing less waste, ultimately saving the company money. In addition, wave soldering would be more efficient and effective than reflow soldering. Instead of gluing each part, the entire PCB would be sprayed with molten solder. The Casio CTK-800 is a reliable portable keyboard. However, in the last 10 years, new technologies have prompted a multitude of improvements. For example, an ideal keyboard would be made out of lighter materials for the purpose of easy transportation. It would also have sound engine technology to recreate the sound of acoustic instruments, and a bigger matrix with minimal wiring, which would be capable of having 88 keys as opposed to the 61 the CTK-800 has. To supplement the musician's craft, the keyboard would have refined musical capabilities such as transposition and music writing software. Weighted keys, hammer action, and touch sensitivity would further enhance the input. A possible improvement for the screen is an additional touch sensory input for ease of navigation through keyboard settings, tones, and volume. Lastly, with advancements in lithium-ion rechargeable batteries, it would be possible to develop a digital keyboard capable of being charged for easy transportation.
Why, hello there! Welcome to the end of our REP video. As you can see next to me are credits for this fantastic film that you have the honor of seeing. Sorry, I'm extremely tired right now. It's like 3 a.m., I think. I don't really know. There's no clock in here. Oh look! That's my name! It's not really big, though. I can fix that. Much better. Well, thank you so much for watching. I will see you at some point later, I think, I hope, I don't know. Please give us an A.